right now. Just want to know if in the group, is there any
So what we're gonna do before we start taking minutes, just so we know who's here, we're gonna do this like we do in IL Canada. Right? We're gonna do this like we do at IL Canada. We're gonna pass the paper around and you put your names. So then our recording secretary record the minutes.
Okay.
So you need a chair.
Here's the pen here, so that you can pass it around. Put your name on that.
Robbie, do you need a chair?
No. Okay. I'll get one later, but I'm fine for now. I got a chair over here with wheels. So anyway, so we're going to review a little bit of 2015 and 2016. But before all that, and everyone should have a, you know, if you need an audited financial statement,
now's the time. Anybody wants to look at a, or have an audited financial statement that hasn't seen one already? Okay, we have one request.
Okay, one.
Anybody else?
Already. Is that not this thing?
I had one on the table there, a spare one. Did that be used up?
Yeah, we need one more.
Okay, I'll go print up another. Are you all gone? I'll go print up more.
One more, I think.
Rob, you can have mine.
Okay, you want to pass that to?
Yeah, pass it to the lady.
Okay.
Yeah,
absolutely.
We want to save the trees.
Save the trees.
I don't want to create too much paper for the. Anyway, so I guess before I want, you know, I wanted to start off today wanting to thank the volunteers in the group, and there's most of you, almost all of you are volunteers, and I should know. Times like today in April, as you know, every year, April, our projects, a lot of the projects that we apply for end. They end at March 31st. So we go back to, you know, we have a few employees. We have Melissa, direct funding person, and she was out doing presentations today and is not here, not available to be here. And we have Joseph, our custodian. We have Bianca. We have a lot of great volunteers, all of you. We're a great team, and you know, we can accomplish a lot, and we have. Oh my God, yeah, it's been amazing. Recently, we'll talk about growing together in a second, but I wanted to talk about employees and the capacity here at the center. You know what? We only have a few employees, but it's you volunteers that makes this place fly and roll, including Mr. Ticolo and including Mr. Black, and including the rest of the board members that aren't able to be here. It's a fantastic, amazing, like, without help and volunteers, I mean, we wouldn't be here right now. Am I right? Am I lying?
No.
No? You got it. And if it wasn't for you members, we wouldn't be here right now. This is why we're here. This is, and it's nice because the center's ran, you know, by people with disabilities, for people with disabilities, and it's also everyone's helping, and that's what, and you got volunteers in that kitchen right now that are working so hard, and let me tell you, it's unbelievable. We should be very proud of ourselves. We got a beautiful center, and I say this every year, we got volunteers that keep this place running, and we got, the government has been very helpful, different levels of government, and that. But you know, we make our own funding. We got people out there fundraising. We got people that are making this place work. My personal thing with independent living, it's a very special place. It offers me and us an opportunity to be citizens of Sudbury and community and be able to be to contribute to our lives, to to make this life the best ever. And we do it together in a big family here. Big group. It's such an amazing, and I'm very proud and lucky to be part of it all. And you know, these two guys on the here have been amazing volunteers. Everyone's been amazing. So it just works. Independent living works. It gives people with disabilities the choice to do whatever they'd like in this world, to from hiring your own personal support workers to, you know, going to school or coming in here to hang out or volunteer or whatever. You know, and it's flexible. You can come in whenever you'd like. You can be part. You can be. It works because you control your destiny. You control what you do. And that big steering wheel of life, you get to steer that wheel. You get to turn that wheel. You get to go. You could be here right now. You can volunteer. You could be out there. You could be at the Y. You could be at the pool. You could be wherever you want. So you make your own decisions. And that's what I like about independent living. It's not a prescribed. Nobody's telling us what to do. We're here because we want to be here. Nobody here is here because they have to be here. It's because we want to be here. It's because we're all here together, right? Does that make sense? Yeah. Is that fine? Like, I don't know. And I'm just fortunate that I'm here with you, and that we're celebrating together this wonderful. We're celebrating a tough year, 2015. It was a tough year. Oh my God. Well, we had an economic downturn. We had all this stuff going on in the world and in Canada. A lot of financial problems and governments closing the purse. And we had a lot of problem, but we fought through it. And we still have a fight to go, but it's a lot easier. This year has been a lot smoother. Last year was tough. I mean, there was funding cuts. There was issues and concerns and. Somehow we made it through a really bad year last year. It was tough, but we did it together. It's about being together. And the only we did it because we're all doing it. We're all helping each other out here. Every time we get to those malls, every time we fundraise, every time somebody comes in and says, hey, I'd like to volunteer. Great. That's one step closer to our goal of having an inclusive society, a place where we all belong, and a place where we all fit, where we all, the war people fought and died for is to give us freedom and be able to have the right to have this beautiful place, and give us entitlement for this place. It gave us entitlement to have the right to live our lives to the fullest. We're entitled to this. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Do you guys follow this? You're entitled. You're entitled to have a better quality of life. People died for this. People ran, you know, fought wars to give us freedom, to be able to give us direction in the world, and to be able to have that big steering wheel of life and be able to turn it whichever direction you want to go to. That's your choice. It's not a prescription. You're not here because you have to be here. You're here because you want to be here. And that counts. That's important, and that's why we're all here. So, that's my little blurb. But I'm here to tell you that I'm very excited. You know, we were gonna go through an audited financial statement. I don't know. It just happens with financial, and sometimes there's tough years. Sometimes there's awesome years. I mean, one year we bought a building. One year last year we struggled a little bit, but it wasn't that bad. We all did it together, okay? So I want the meeting to go on. I want the meeting to go on, but I just want to say that I'm very proud. I'm very humbled that I'm part of this. So and we want to continue. We want to grow the family here. We want to invite your friends and family to come out to the center. We want people to come here. We want to be out in the community. We want to be telling people that, you know what, you know, you can do whatever you'd like in this world as long as you put your mind to it and set some goals and set some short-term, some long-term. We all heard that many times, but it works, and that's what we need to do here. And so it's amazing. What else can I tell you? I think this year is going to be a great year. I have a feeling. that's all I have to tell you. I mean, it's only April, right? It's the beginning of our fiscal year. Our year starts April 1st and goes all the way and ends March 31st. So that's our year, our fiscal year. So, like I said, March 31st, projects end, and then they'll come back. It's like this every year. It just happens. There's times, April and sometimes May, and a lot of the members that have been here for many years have noticed, mm-hmm. projects end, and then projects begin. It's a nice refresh, but, you know, there's certain things that we want. Like, we want to have those programs running all year round, and that's our goal, and that's what we want to do. And we're going to raise our own funds to do it. And you're probably going to hear very soon in the meeting how we're going to try and raise those dollars, maybe to keep key employees here full time, to have projects running, to sports or whatever. We want to keep this going, and that's our goal. And we're going to fight to get it there. I mean, we need to. It's for us. It's for all of us.
It's a work in progress.
And it's for people with disabilities. I'm going to say in the world, and I'm going to say in the world, because in our corner of this world. This is what we like, that we've made this place. You, all the youth members, we voted on the building, we voted on the format and how the offices and how the format, how this place was built. Everyone had a say in that. We had a say to coming up to 125 Durham, and we're going to have a say in the future as well. We're going to have a say in the direction we're going to go in. That's what we do. That's why I love this place. That's why I'm so passionate. It's because I believe in it, and I hope you do too. And I hope if you're not sure, I hope you listen tight to the meeting tonight. And it's for all of us. That's what I wanted to tell you. I know it's kind of, but I'm just talking to you from my heart, and I'm telling you that keep up the fight. We want to have. You're entitled to this. We want to continue. You're entitled to have a better quality of life, an awesome quality of life. You're entitled to earn money. You're entitled to have a job. You're entitled to go to school. You're entitled to come into IL, be part of IL family. You're entitled to help. You're entitled to do whatever you like. And we want to do it to make you better. And it's about increasing, you know, the quality of life for everyone here and beyond. And to advocate for change. Am I talking too much?
Yeah.
Am I
saying nice crowd, Rob?
Am I saying any lies?
No. We may not be a prescription, but we're natural remedies.
Right.
What
else? What do you think? Like, tell me. I want to hear. Just speak up. So, what do you think of what I said? Am I wrong?
Yeah. No. Long-term goal: supportive housing. Yeah.
Okay, that's your goal, and that could be part of all of us. We have to do this together, and we have to do that. We can do whatever we can. We can build a building. We can build a skyscraper. Whatever we decide to do, we put our energy there, and we might get it. We more than likely are going to get it. We have to work on this together. You know, it's something we all work together, and that's what it is. That's why I love it.
No more Rumble Terrace.
There's in Sudbury and Ontario and beyond. We're continuing to work to give people with disabilities. And the better quality of life. And I keep saying that because that's my message today, is we're here to give people with disabilities the quality of life that you're entitled to have. And people have died for this. They have fought wars. They've had, there's people in Parliament arguing right now. Then these two nice men here have argued and have worked and have made this place. And you've all helped, and everyone here. So that's my thing. We're entitled to a better quality of life.
Can I add to that?
Yeah, please.
The years independent living influenced the community. I remember a few years back there was a lot of stores, businesses, they didn't have the chair accessible. Now because they're getting to know us, a lot of businesses put a ramp for us, so it helps us to live more independently and gets us out of our house. So because of us, because of independent living, it's positive in the community.
That's awesome. Thanks, Janine. That's very touching. I love it.
I've noticed that a lot of businesses are understanding that we need ramps here right now.
Yes, we do.
Yeah, a lot of them work in the sidewalks. They worked in downtown Sudbury before,
The government has put the LODA in there to help. And
there are, like, used to be like a drop, and now people in a chair, like me being new to a chair, it's more accessible. I'm not so afraid to go out anymore.
wonderful.
And you have done well since you left Dillon Creek too.
Oh God, yeah.
Oh yeah.
Done that
a lot safer place.
Thanks for speaking up. Anybody else want to speak up? You're welcome to. We're all together. So we want to grow the group. We want more people to come. Invite everybody that want to be here and bring people here. Show them around. You know, this is your place too.
Rob, can I say something on behalf of Martin?
No, I'd like you to speak for yourself, please.
Something Martin said to me.
Okay.
I want to repeat something he said to me. This is a volunteer student that comes in. And he came in the other day, and we have it's his last day today. And he was telling us that his parents wanted him to come here this summer because since coming here, he's much more pleasanter. And we've had a very positive influence on him, and he really wants to come here. And it was just a positive feedback from somebody that didn't ask me.
Yeah,
he just loves coming in with us.
It was lovely seeing him today with the card, and we all were around him thanking him for his good work.
Carol wants to say something.
Yeah, go ahead, Carol.
Actually, I'm speaking for myself.
Yes, please.
Since I've been doing the tickets, I had a compliment from Ken saying that I've done more mature stuff, not being on my phone, not being texting, interacting more with people, coming to the table, buying a ticket, and I've been doing a good job selling tickets.
Oh, you guys have been awesome. And we're going to get to that soon, but fantastic work. You volunteers, this place running, and keep the place going. It's everybody helping, and anybody else want to? I'm okay with that if you want to, and then we'll pass it over to Craig and Earl after this. But does anybody else want to talk from your heart?
Go ahead.
Go ahead.
Okay. Talking about the wheelchair, I would do anything if I could make my building wheelchair accessible. We have had 3 engineers tell us how much we tear the building down we can.
Yeah.
So that is my biggest concern. I feel horrible about that. It's a heritage building on top of that, so we wouldn't even be able to if we drive.
Well, maybe we should rip it down, eh? Put up a new building that's wheelchair accessible. Yeah, I'm about that.
Let's keep the heritage building and let's put a ramp on it.
Let's tear it down. Let's put a ramp up.
Put our supportive housing unit over there.
Anyway, I'm a little bit bold, but I'd like to pass it on.
Rob, we have a young lady over here who wants to say something.
Since I've been coming to the center and we get patted on Elm Street, I've learned to talk in front of crowds. This is a big crowd for me. I wouldn't talk in front of more than 3 people, and now I don't have a problem.
I'm so proud of you.
Myself.
Myself
and Cheryl, we go to the Canadian Hearing Society, and just a few get chosen to go to a special camp that's held this summer from August 13th to the 19th, and I'm going to get choked up here. I got chosen to go. I've been raising my money myself. It's costing me $500, but it's for intense training on sign language. And my goal is to get my master's so I can be an interpreter and go into courts and wherever I'm needed.
Wow. Congratulations.
Sudbury itself, can you call it more time? And there's definitely a shortage of people with sign language in Sudbury itself.
Yeah, well, I know as a mission there's a deaf fellow there, and last summer there was an altercation where the cops were trying to talk to him. He didn't understand. And I asked the officer, I said, can I, come in? I'm just, new to this class, not even 2 weeks, and I knew how to interpret it enough to assist him, so he didn't get arrested and thrown in jail, treated dirt. So I was able to help him.
Thank you. That's wonderful. Yes, do it. I love it.
I want to segue to the rest of the meeting, but I'm going to just jump on one of the themes that I want Earl to respond as well. We have something really exciting for you guys tonight. And I don't just say that just because I'm trying to get your attention or get reelected. That's not what I'm here to do. But I think we've got something really exciting for you guys tonight. And Earl was going to talk about it. I'm going to talk about it. But I'm going to leave you in suspense for a couple of minutes. But when I heard what I heard tonight, I think, Earl, at least from my heart and probably yours, I think that really affirms the direction that we want to go. Isn't that right, Chris? Yeah. Amazing stuff. So thank you very much. I'm going to give you guys more time for feedback later. But I do want to get the meeting going because I know you guys have buses to catch. And Brian wants to watch the Blue Jays game because, you know, he likes baseball.
Can't watch the Leafs.
I like baseball.
You never mind.
So I'd like to start the meeting. So let me just do a couple of real quick things. I usually have a big parcel of highlights during the year, and I may forget a few things. And if I forget, I'm going to ask you guys to chime in. I think that would be the easiest way to deal with this. 2015, in some ways, was a difficult year. Why? Because we had a lot of people here, a lot of employees here, trying to serve everyone here, and it got difficult. We have a relatively small space. And, you know, I think we did quite well, and so I just want to highlight a few things. First of all, we had our 2015 International Day of Persons with Disabilities breakfast. Man, that was an awesome breakfast.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it was great. And, you know, you have to think of who the speaker was. It wasn't Ryan Benoit. Who was the year before Ryan? Anybody remember? I can't think, but...
Wasn't that what's
her
name?
Andrew Olivier.
Andrew Olivier.
Yeah.
Yeah, Andrew.
Yeah.
That was a great time, you know. Everyone had a wonderful time. Another well-attended event. Here's the scoop, guys. Over $20,000 was raised at that breakfast.
Oh,
okay. Amazing. Okay? So that was exciting. And then we had our gala dinner. That was a good event, too. That was a good event. And you know what? We raised the money for that. And, you know, I think what's exciting is that our group is doing new things. I'm going to talk about that in a minute. And I think the other thing that was really exciting is we keep adding to this building. Now, this year we didn't have the exciting thing maybe of buying the building, moving in like we did in 2014. Everybody remembers how much fun that was, how excited we all were? I'll never forget. But I'll tell you, 2015 was a good year. You know why? Because we were able to add to the value of this building. Right? What did we do? First thing we did, we put a new big roof up there. That was in 2015, guys. The roof, the big roof, this whole big thing here, all this area, brand new roof. Here's the thing, brand new roof, and we didn't have to borrow from the bank. Now think about that. We put a $50,000 addition on this building. We didn't borrow from it. That's you guys. That's a highlight as far as I'm concerned. You know what I'm getting at? It's exciting. What else did we have? We had a sports program. Good program. Everyone enjoyed it. All except for Cherie, but we won't go there, right? But it was a good program. We did some good stuff there. And we had another nice lady join us, too. Anybody know who Monica Hoffman is? You know who Monica is?
Yeah.
She was here today.
Yeah. She's here today?
Yeah.
Guess what? She started coming out in that year, ended March 31st, 2015. Does she make a difference around here?
Yeah.
You bet she does. arts and crafts, work, helps out with proposals, helps you guys out. Wonderful lady, right?
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah.
That's a highlight, as far as I'm concerned. So, we had a lot of great things happen last year, 2015. What? Well, that's for next year. But we'll talk about it anyway. And even though it kind of goes into the next fiscal year, we introduced a new event. Cruising for Inclusion. Remember that?
Yeah.
That was fun.
Guess what? That's coming back.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
We're going to talk about that.
Yeah.
We're going to talk about that.
That was a blast.
Okay? So you know what? That was a tough year financially. It's the first time I can ever remember in many years that we actually had a loss on the bottom line. But guess what? It was a good year. You know why it was a good year? Because you guys made it a good year. You guys did the work. You guys did the sweating. Earl's job, my job, well, you know what? Our job is to keep this place going and thinking and being progressive. And I think we did that. Again, to a large extent. So I think it was a good year. And I want to say something before I forget. You know, listening to Rob speak is always really, really enjoyable for me. He tends to use a word a lot. Have you ever noticed he uses the word amazing a lot?
Yes.
I mean it.
How many times do you think he used amazing in his talk tonight?
Lots of times.
12 times, maybe 14?
If not more.
If not more.
I lost
track after about 14.
Yeah.
But I want to say something. And I'm not a guy who says amazing too often. But I think Earl said it right. You know, when we pay Rob, he should be getting more than what he's getting paid.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
I'm not joking. You know what? Guys, we have an amazing executive director.
Oh, thanks.
No kidding.
Absolutely.
For sure.
Amazing guy.
Where's your whistle there?
I
bet when he sleeps, he does stuff for us too.
You know what? I've never seen a guy like Rob. This guy, you know, I'll just give you an example. Last week, or I think it was maybe 2 weeks ago, I came in here. And I called Rob during the week. I said, Rob, can I come over? I want to talk to you. Rob was a bit down. I said, I'm going to talk to you. I want to cheer you up. And that's what we did. For 2 hours, you did nothing but talk. And guess who did most of the talking?
Not you.
It wasn't me.
Rob.
But shall we say this, though?
I need to talk.
Okay, absolutely.
Yeah.
He needs to talk, too. But here's the thing. I've met a lot of executive directors at IL, Earl and I, over the years. Mm-hmm. I've met them from all over Canada, from British Columbia to Halifax to St. John's and all points in between. But I can tell you this, there's not one guy or one lady that works harder than Rob. And I'm not joking. He works hard.
We know that.
And you know what? You know what? Mm-hmm. He needs your appreciation.
Yeah, we don't like them all.
I know.
Seriously,
you know what?
I'm second.
You know what? Listen, guys. We need to give Rob a serious hand clap.
Previous ones.
Honestly, guys,
thank you.
Honestly, we're fortunate, and I think we're all blessed.
Oh, yes.
And I say that without any word of lie.
God bless.
So, you know what? I think Rob does an amazing job. And I want to say thank you to you guys, too, because like Rob said, he said it, and I won't say more. If it wasn't for you guys, Earl and I wouldn't need to be here, because what can we do? We're just two people. You know, if two people can't get a bunch of people engaged, we're wasting time. But I know everyone who comes here believes that this is worth it. Every minute you spend, every ticket you sell, every phone call you make, every smile you give to anybody. You guys are awesome ambassadors. And I'm very, very, very thankful that so many of you come here daily, monthly, weekly, faithfully. You're the guts. You guys are the centers here. Earl and I, we're just the bit guys. We come in, we do a little bit of thinking, and we do a lot of planning, but you know what? You guys are the guys that make it work. Thank you. So, I think it was a good year. Would you not agree?
Yep. Yes.
A fine year.
Good year. So, I think we've sort of exhausted this topic at the moment. So, if you don't mind, could we go to the fight? Oh, by the way, Bianca, don't leave yet. I want to give Bianca a hand clap.
Oh, yeah.
This is supposed to be dinner club, right?
Yes.
So did everyone pay $12 to Bianca?
Yes.
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
To me.
No. For those of you, to Jen?
To me.
Okay, Jen. I didn't pay you because I didn't know who was collecting, but you make sure you remind me.
I will.
Okay.
And I want to pay too.
Yeah. Anybody who hasn't paid?
I have to pay the bank machine.
Anybody who hasn't paid, go see Jen.
Okay.
But I want to say thank you, Bianca. The meal was wonderful. It was great.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
Fantastic.
Excellent.
Awesome.
Sometime
great
next week I'll come by and pay my $12.
Sounds like a plan.
Yeah.
I like it. Okay, so thank you, Bianca. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
I know everyone does here too. Okay. We're gonna turn our attention now to the financial statements. Now I know this is a lot of Greek for some of you guys.
Sorry, before you do that, can I ask who on the board is still missing or who is absent?
Yeah.
I know that Craig is not.
Craig Barkley is not here.
We know that. And
Amber Perry is not here.
But that's it for the board?
Amber Perry, yeah.
Okay, you got that?
Yeah.
Amber Perry?
Yeah, P-E-R-R-Y.
Okay, anybody else on the board?
No, that's it.
Okay, so then we've got the list of who attended the meeting and then that's it from the board.
You got it.
Okay, is there anybody else that didn't sign this before?
Anybody who didn't sign the sign-in sheet? So you know, those of you guys who signed the sign-up sheet, you order all $10, so you'll be expecting to
pay. We wish.
The reason we had everybody sign up, right? Just kidding. All right. Okay. If we can turn our attention now to the financial statements, I think you've all had a chance to look at them. I'm not going to review them in detail, but I am going to point out a few things that I think we should point out as we go ahead. So, there's a couple of things that caught my eye. Number one, we have new auditors this year by the name of BDO, who did an excellent job, I want to let you know. Mm-hmm. And actually gave us a very good deal on their rate. I was quite pleased with the work they did. They were, to Rob's chagrin, they were very
thorough.
Very thorough.
Oh, God, yeah.
You know, that pain look you saw in Rob's face in the middle of the summer, it was that look of pain when they're going, Rob, you need to get us six more things.
Yeah.
And Rob goes, but I don't know where those are. Well, you're going to find them. Anyway.
25 more things.
And 25 more things on top of that. So, you know what, this is a lot of work. And whatever we pay the auditors this year was worth it. And I say that very sincerely. So, I want to sort of go through this. If I can take you to page, I can't see very well here, but I'm going to take you to page 4. Statement of our financial position. Okay? Now, Rob already said it, but basically our assets for this year went down $800,000 to $760,570. And so we had a bit of a, as Rob said, the government purse was not quite so active. I can tell you, and I think Earl would agree with me, that this was one of the worst years for getting money from the federal government. And the reason why, of course, you know why? We have an election. As soon as they hear the word election, the coffers run dry.
oh, we can't do anything, it's election coming. So there we were. Okay, so that's why that happened. So I'm going to move on from page 4 of the financials. And I'm going to go through to page 5, the next page. You'll notice that our total revenues for 2015 were $513,143. That's a good number. Put that in perspective. $500,000 worth of revenue comes through the center. Put it in English, about $42,000 every month.
Wow.
Comes through. Okay. Our expenses, well, our expenses were up this year. And the main reason was, I saw it right away, salaries and benefits. And for one of the first years I can remember in several years, I think early three, we have a slight deficiency at the bottom line. Fortunately, though, we had several good years where we had a surplus, and so we were able to absorb a small deficiency of about $21,642. So I just wanted to let you know what was going on there. But I want to take you to some more exciting stuff, if I can, because there was something that really got my mojo going. And anybody who knows me knows when I get my mojo going, that's scary. But I want to take you to page 10. Okay? And what we have in page 10 is we have a statement of our capital assets.
Notes to financial statement?
Yep. Okay. Notes to financial. Looking at note 6. On page 10, right in the middle of the page, entitled Capital Assets. We have land, guys. This building where we are situated right now, the dirt, is worth $143,903.
That's just the property.
That's just the dirt.
That's just the dirt.
You take the building off of here, we got $150,000 we're sitting on.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. Now you add the building. Okay? $590,577. That's what this building's worth, guys. Now I'm going to put this in perspective. A year ago, when we had our former accountants, the accountant with me was giving Rob a hard time, and Rob said, well, did we make any money this year? It was a really intelligent question. He said, but the building had ran at a loss. Well, let me tell you something. We bought this building 2 years ago, a little over 2 years ago, for $390,000.
Wow.
Okay? Based on these numbers here, our profit, our building has increased in value.
Yeah.
Through all the things we put in here, by $200,000.
Wow.
That's phenomenal.
Yeah.
Now that's amazing, guys. So I just did a quick eyeball of this. Just my quick math. Our land and buildings, guys, together, taken together, we're looking at $744,000.
Wow.
Does anybody remember when we were on Elm Street?
Yes.
Remember that?
Yeah.
How much was the land and buildings that we owned on Elm Street, guys?
Nothing.
Zero.
Zip.
We were renting.
We were renters.
Exactly.
Yeah.
We were paying the landlord.
Has it been worthwhile to be owners?
Yeah. Yes.
Oh, hell yeah.
You know, we go to the bank now, guys. We need something. You know what the answer is?
Yeah.
No problem.
Yeah.
You've got lots of equity. They're not worried about us.
Yeah.
They'll give us what we want.
Yeah.
You know, I remember Broken the test 3 years ago when we bought this building. We couldn't get a bank to look at us.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you can't do this. And we said, why the fuck can't we
He said it like it is.
I'm not making that up. One time, like I had Jeff Dixon was so mad he started cursing at the bank manager.
Oh my.
Which bank did you do the deal?
Northern Credit Union.
Yes.
And that's our bank.
Yes.
Locally owned. Yeah.
Guess what? Locally owned, locally operated. You know, I talked to Shirley Smith a couple of months ago. She came to my office. I ask her this question every year just because I want to make sure that I'm getting the answer I want to hear. Shirley, are you glad you invested in us? Us being independent living? Sudbury, Manitoulin? You know what her answer was, Earl? Absolutely.
Well, she walks in with a big smile.
She's doing it again.
And we run to her for a hug.
She's doing it again.
So you know what, guys?
I can tell you this, and I'm not bullshitting anybody here. Maybe aside from perhaps two independent living centers in Canada,
yeah,
or three, there ain't too many independent living centers sitting on a $750,000 property. That, I can assure you. And that doesn't count the revenue that comes in here. It's part of it. The people upstairs, Arsenal Folsom. You know what? Next time you see Mr. Folsom comes in here, thank him.
Well, I do.
This guy puts $60,000 a year in our pockets. $5,000 every month.
Wow.
Is he happy that he's a tenant?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
You bet your dollar he's.
You remember
when
he
like
that with glasses.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay? Yeah, he's a great guy. Guess what? We make this work, all of us here. But I wanted to point this out to you, because you know sometimes we take the building for granted. This is not to be taken for granted, guys. You, not me. I'm only a little tiny part. Earl's only a little tiny part. You guys, selling those cookies. Selling those raffle tickets, getting those memberships, helping on the breakfast. You're the people that gave us the money years ago to buy a piece of dirt. Well, guess what the piece of dirt turned into? A center. A home. A $744,000 home.
Can I throw some money?
Well, I'm going to pay.
Dark Creighton.
So, I just want to say that, because you know what? I think it was a good year. I think it was a good year because we added to the equity and is the profit in our own building.
Now you understand. I mean, you got the roof, that $50,000 roof.
That's exciting.
Yeah, I get it.
You know, we could have done nothing. Sure, we should have showed a surplus at the end of the day, right? Oh, look, you made money.
We could have put a bucket under the dripping roofs.
Right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Already got in the roof.
But we fixed it.
We don't put a bucket under there. It's a leak.
But we fixed it. And guess what? Here's what else we did. After that, just to move the story a little further ahead, we put a brand new air conditioning unit on the other side. Because we want to attract a good tenant. We did that this year. You'll hear about that in the 2016 AGM. We talked about this year. But you see, part of the things that we do here, we improve your house. We improve our house. Right? This is a project. This is a labor of love here. We improve our heartbeat. You guys benefit. That is what I call a good year.
Is there any other maintenance projects other than the elevator and then going downstairs? The rest of it is all in good shape.
Yes.
Do we know if next door is rented or not?
I don't have anything official. I'm going to give you a better answer than that. We are very close to officially renting next door.
That's
I can't say that it's done yet.
No. Devin's had another dotted line, as you would put it.
But we're very close.
We're really close.
Okay. Now the other thing is, so we know, we've also had, just for interest, we've had some people interested going downstairs too.
So that would give a little bit more than
we could have done. Yeah, that's it. So, you know, we're close on a couple of fronts. Yep. I can assure you though that once we know, we'll get Rob to tell everybody the word, because that'll be a good time for us. And I'll tell you what else I did, just because I think I should let you know. We care about you guys. We want you to have an awesome center. And I have been, and Earl can tell you, and Earl's been the same. We're very careful about what we do with that space over here. We want to make sure that we get a quality tenant.
Yes.
And I'll tell you what I was doing yesterday. When everybody was out of here, I'm looking for some space for the sports program. You know why? Because I think the sports program is important. I think the sports program needs a place to live. I want to do more things in here, but I'm not done yet.
Well, the gentleman here is phenomenal.
Yeah, but I want to do more. I want to do more. So guess what? I'm always pushing the boundaries. And we're talking about that. So we'll see how that goes. But I think we'll have some really positive news reports. Probably, I'm hoping, in a week or two.
Yeah.
And when we do, Rob will announce. And hopefully you guys will be really excited, because I'm excited. I'm excited. So,
if I could, I'd like to explain where I'm coming from. I am a volunteer here, as you all know. But I am past president of the Autism Society. And my son was 19 when we found out that he had Asperger's syndrome. I've got to get a little bit of history from that, so you understand where I'm coming from. After 21, there's no place for any adult, no matter what the disability, in this town, to come and be total acceptance. And I have been looking. My son is now 34. And I have been looking for something. He's fine. He's out doing his life. But in my case, for me, I wanted the people that are coming behind me to have something set up that they didn't have to go through what I did. And it's always been in my thing. So one day I was talking with Doc, because Rob and I go back a long way. If you can't come away, I talk about him. But we go back a long, long way. What, 20 plus years now? Just a couple of years. But I came to Rob and I said, I want to do something fun. I've done this, I've done that, you know, like I've been on palliative care, I've done the CNID, I've all kinds of other organizations. And I don't know if you remember, we go back, way back, when this was first being discussed, I was involved back then. But my Jimmy took me a different route, although I still kept watching. I've always watched the development of here. And then Rob said, well, come in here. And I had a couple of projects of my own to do, this, you know, they were mine. And I got downstairs, you know, with the filing and the shredding. That was fun. But that's another story. That's it. There was more than a week. But that's another
Rob's
story.
Rob went over downstairs on a snow day doing shredding because it was entertaining.
It's a
great stress reliever.
But anyways, we're digressing. But what I want to say here is that this foundation in this place, I can see the potential. I see the dream. And it's part of a dream that I have had. And I've made contact finally with the Autism Society. And she's come in and did a presentation for us. And she sees the dream. She sees the connection for our adults. Because you can come in here, it's total acceptance. You can be as quirky as you want. You can do whatever. The only things we do ask is, like, don't come in with junk, don't come in junk. And what's the profanity? But if you can't handle it, say you've got Tourette's and you can't handle it, it's total acceptance. We just explained they can't change that. It's total acceptance, which is what I like. And then we're coming in here. So she's excited now to start bringing autistic people in here. And we do have some that do come in already that have come in through the, I'm trying to think of his name, it's Adam Reynolds. And his father is one of the founding members of the Autism Sudbury. So it's spreading. It's coming.
We're getting roots.
The roots are coming. And they're taking hold. And look at this place in another 5 years, look at it in 10 years, and you're going to be, oh my God. Because I can see, I can see the vision of. Okay, one place there, and I'm not going to talk anymore.
One more thing I'm going to say that I forgot before I leave the financial statement. If you look at page 11, item number 9 is our long-term debt.
You know this one.
Okay. Well, in 2014, we owed $281,026. At the end of this fiscal period, 2015, we owed $266,200. So guess what? This year, we also reduced our debt by how much?
$15,000.
$15,000.
Wow.
So I think it was a good year. I just wanted to point that out. Thank you. So now that I've gone through the financial statement, board, you all to help. Can I have someone move the acceptance of these financial minutes?
I'm not talking about
a lot of people.
Carol, seconded by Charles.
Okay, got that.
All in favor?
You.
Yeah.
Yo. Okay, that means yo. Okay. Anybody opposed? Let's hope not.
No, everything makes sense.
Carry.
As in pennies as well.
Carry. Okay, good stuff. Okay. I'm going to do things a little differently. We don't have scrutineers tonight. So you got me and Earl. Lucky you guys. So what I'm going to suggest is this. There's four people you're voting for. Craig Barkley, Earl, myself, and Amber. And as you know, we do it by a slate. That's our slate. Now, I'm going to talk about board members in a minute, but I think we should just go through the formality. All in favor of the slate as read or read out by me. All in favor, hands.
Putting up for
Cheryl. Cheryl, okay.
My toes up.
Works for me.
Your toes up, too.
I think that's pretty much unanimous. Okay.
That's cute.
Here you go. Okay, let me just talk about board members for a minute. As you can see, we have a small number of board members. Some good things happen, but I want to throw it out to you guys. Independent living is not a closed operation. We're very transparent, I think, the way we operate. And I've said to Rob on several occasions, and I'm going to say it publicly, if any of you want to be on the board of directors, you only have to do two things. They're very simple. One, you tell Rob you're interested. Does everybody understand that?
Yeah.
Okay. Number two, then we will sit you down and we'll talk to you for a few minutes. That will be all you need. So, if any of you are interested, and I know Carol's contacted me, I haven't forgotten, Carol. You're on the list.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I'm actually meeting with you on Thursday.
I know. Bianca.
I'm interested.
Okay. Bianca?
I'd like to give it a shot.
Yeah, what's your first name?
Marlene.
Marlene. Okay, Charles?
Yeah.
Okay. I grew up with Robbie, Charles.
Okay. So, Madam Recording Secretary, have we noted the names that are interested?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, just so we all know, you know, because Earl and I don't get paid, we have to get paid some way. So anybody who wants to come and be part of the board, they have to pay a small initiation fee. It's payable to my friend Mr. Black here.
What's that, two large double-double?
That's about it.
Okay. I can handle that.
Okay. I'm just joking. But no, please, if those of you who are interested, we're going to have a jamboree on Thursday.
Oh,
this is how it's going to work. I told Rob, we're going to start at 5 o'clock. Guess what? We're going to go until we're done. That's as simple as it's going to be. sleep, that means we're taking too much time. but here's the thing, guys, and I want to be serious about that. We want you guys that are here on a daily basis or regularly to tell us. We need you. I'm not here all the time. I hear what goes on here all the time. But I'm not here all the time. Big difference. Earl hears a lot of stuff all the time. But Earl isn't here all the time. We need your eyes. We need your ears. We need your minds. We need you. So thank you for telling us you're interested. And we're going to make it work. We're going to find room for you. You may have to have a double-decker board table. our next expansion might be to knock out that wall so I can fit everybody in there and get a smaller board table, but we'd be more than interested to have you guys, so thank you, okay? So we will have interviews and we'll go from there, okay? Make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Carly.
Is this thing happening on Thursday? Because I'm doing an exam until
6 o'clock. Well, here's what we're going to do. We'll have you at another time when it's convenient.
Okay. Because I go to school on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday.
Yeah.
But
can you talk to Rob about that?
No.
About when you're available? About when you're available? Can you talk to Rob?
I can. Okay. But I have my final exam on Thursday,
sure.
And it's like 8 hours. Yeah, I also won't be able to make this one because I am in floor hockey.
Okay.
But one day when I have a chance, I will talk to Robbie.
Okay. So you let Rob know when you're available, okay? We'll do it. I like to have all you guys, so you know what? Wouldn't it be nicer if we actually had a group of maybe 10 or 11 people around here? That would be cool.
Oh, yeah.
We haven't had that for a long time. No, that's exciting.
And Mama G can bring her guitar over.
Oh, I like that.
I love it.
I like that. Okay. So, thank you very much. So, I appreciate your help. So, madam, go ahead. Somebody has something to say?
No.
Okay,
just before, do you want to recap the name of the people that are interested?
Yeah, please, if you mind.
Being on the board, Bianca, Marlene, Carol, and myself, Pauline. And who else? Anybody else?
Hi.
Charles. Yeah. So, okay, if you're going on the board, how often do you meet?
Once a month. The meetings are pretty quick. They start at approximately, what time do they start? At 5, 5:30?
They're done by 7.
Yeah. We rock. We don't fool around.
And that's this Thursday, right?
Yeah. Or whatever.
Yeah, this is for the initial visit. Like, you know, they're going to talk to you and say, this is what we want you to do.
Yeah, well, maybe I'll con my teacher to do extending my exam.
Con your teacher? No, don't con your teacher.
Oh, no. I saw something on his desk.
Well, don't fail your course and blame me.
Oh, I'm
going
to get AC
net.
Like,
okay.
My lowest mark.
Well,
was
whatever, Marlene, whatever's comfortable for you, we're happy, okay?
Yeah.
But thank you for your interest. We really appreciate that. You've also had people rock in and out of the Northern Life, and there are also other people that are interested. You know what? That's exciting, too. Because you know what that means? New blood. New blood in the center.
Yeah.
That's exciting. So, no, that'll be one of the fun things, actually. I thought we were done, but it'll be fun. Thank you. Okay. I want to talk. Actually, I need a little question. Earl, Robbie was making some comments about how he sort of envisioned the center. So maybe what we should do is maybe hear from you. But we're going to do something new. We're going to do something brand new here at the center. Never been done before. And I'm just gonna say it like this. Earl's gonna start and go for as long as he wants, then I'm gonna finish. But it's a new concept for our center, a new tagline. You know what a tagline is? Like a new slogan.
Okay.
New slogan for the center. So Earl, do you want to introduce that and explain how that came about?
You're gonna have to really find me. Okay.
So the new tagline, guys, by the way, guys, which Rob refers to, is this: entitling persons with disabilities to be enabled.
So the old one is perspective on disability. Now we're telling people how we're promoting them.
Okay, say it again, Laura.
Entitling persons. Entitling persons with disabilities to be enabled.
Do you like that? Does anyone?
I love that.
Yeah,
I love
it.
Yeah, same.
I love that.
What do you think?
There's disabled and there's disabled. Different ability to everyone as well.
And what do you guys think of that?
I love that.
I like
that
it.
Able?
Why do you like it?
Yeah.
Why do you like it?
I like it because it gives more empowerment to people that have disabilities and that can, you know, raise their like opinion, like their voices and stuff. And, you know, other options.
We're just enabling them, right?
Yeah.
Enabling.
There's nothing about disabled.
No.
From the enabled.
Yeah.
Marlene,
what do you think?
It opens the door for people like us that are disabled, and it's not like taking Joe Blow off the street and saying, okay, you can do this. And, you know what I'm.
Yeah, like giving a prescription, like you can do this at that time, you got to be here.
Yeah, and
we're enabling you to
do. But we come in and we can do it at our own pace.
Yeah,
natural remedies.
Well, there is a timeline, but you know you have, say, 2 weeks to get the agenda ready for the next meeting or whatever. You don't have to do it all in one day. You know, like, oh, can't talk to you, I'm busy, I got to do this, Rob's going to kill me. Or, can't do this.
Say that around here.
Oh my God, yes, he's poor. I'm sorry. It's hard.
Going on?
Go ahead,
no,
sorry.
You're not.
Marlene, sorry, go ahead.
It's like we could just take our time on doing it. And I really like that name because I got chills.
Yeah, right now. That's all.
Okay. Teresa, you want
chills.
To say something?
Yes, I was just wondering if we could kind of run a one on one. Meeting with one person and myself or whatever. I do have experience in doing this from Pierce Park, if you remember them.
Yeah.
I used to answer phones,
rings,
and just listen to them. If you don't want to talk, I talk. But maybe look something out of that.
I'm all for that. I love Pierce support. Pierce support is good. Any other opinions on our slogan? What do you think?
Just the last word.
Yeah.
Enable. Can it not be just able?
Enable. It's the same thing.
Yeah, but able would be more positive. I look at it as that gives them the strength to be able.
Yeah.
Enable means somebody's helping you get the strength.
Ability, yeah.
But we're all trying to get our strength. We're all learning.
I think here's the context of it. I understand. Earl and I just don't run these things 5 minutes. Now, Earl and Rob and I have probably talked about this for 10 hours. Okay? I think for the average person, you could say able, it's fine. But think about this. Think about the wider idea. A new person comes in here, brand new person. Some of you guys shared examples. Isn't our job to enable this person? That's our job. Guys, we are disabled only because that's a label somebody else puts to us. But I can tell you this, I say this truthfully. There's not one person in this room I consider disabled. That word doesn't exist really to me. But I can tell you what everyone in this room is or has been. Enabled.
Yeah, you have been enabled.
All of you from each other, from your own experiences and learning from others and doing things, have become able, or the more complicated word is enabled. And guess what, guys? If we're going to grow this place, right? Like you said, it's a good point. Our job, we're going to take somebody who comes in here for the first time and impart the message. A, you're entitled to what, may I ask? Better quality of life, like Rob said. Employment opportunities. right? Medical care. The right to be heard. Express an opinion. Make a decision, right? All that stuff? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Everybody understand that?
Yeah.
Okay. So that's what you are entitled to. But here's the trick. The trick is, it's not just entitlement because you're entitled. You're entitled because you become able. And that's our next step in our growth. A person walks through here, and I talked to Rob about this already. Our job is to put a plan together so that a new person, never been here before, can become enabled for themselves. That's what this is about.
And they have the control.
Absolutely. That's absolutely correct.
I had that when I started here doing the reading program, and that's what I did. I had a fellow, and he said that, I said, you know, you walk. No, it's up, you know, well, it's up to you. And I said, no, it's not. It's up to you. What do you want to do? No, it's up to you. You're the teacher. I said, no. I'm helping you. What do you want to do? And even today, we were reading, and I said, like, you know, through, you know, I said, there's other things I've got to get done. Do you want to be, you know, like, can we stop here? Well, I'd like to read another chapter. And I looked down, and it was like, okay, we'll read another chapter.
There you go.
Because he is the one who's in control. I'm here to help him with those strings attached.
Right.
And no deadline. You go at your speed.
And at the end of that process, that person learns the skills themselves to do all those important things. Right. And that's what's exciting. Right? You know? And to me, when Earl and I discussed this, you know, the first word we used, I'll share a little story. I was thinking about this because, you know, we've had some issues and whatever. And I put this little tagline together. I ran it by Rob. Rob says, I think he's good. Then I ran it by Earl, and Earl said, your tagline's pretty good, but I got a better line for you. He said, well, actually, the way it went was this. I said, Earl, should we say that people are empowered? Should this tagline be empowering persons with disabilities to be enabled? Or entitling persons with disabilities to be enabled? Here's what my friend Earl said. Greg, the word's entitlement. Mm-hmm. And you know what? That's true.
Yeah.
All of us here are entitled.
So this is a new slogan for 2016?
New slogan, I hope, for a long time. Not just for 5 minutes.
Yeah.
This is the new slogan, guys. Anybody else have comments on the slogan?
You like it? You don't like it?
I gotta memorize it. It's okay, we'll give it to you.
Pretty easy, 7 words.
We got some new t-shirts, son.
Here's the bottom line, though, guys. Everyone who walks in here needs to be enabled. And it's a process for every one of us. You know, Earl has a job, works at Laurentia, now he's enjoying retirement. I learn every day in my job. But you know what? You guys inspire us. You help me to help others. So even though you don't think you do anything, you're still enabling me. It's a process. It doesn't stop. It doesn't stop. It continues. It moves. So I hope everyone likes the slogan. Sounds like we've got a lot of good feedback.
What's everybody think?
What do you guys think?
Yeah.
Should we do this?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's quite bold, eh?
From saying, promoting your perspective for disabilities.
Yeah.
To
I make the motion.
Okay.
Can you say this?
Do I make the motion? I saw Marlene second.
Okay, just a second.
Can you repeat the title?
I make the motion to accept the above as our new sudbury chapter.
Yeah, and I'll just repeat the slogan.
Slogan.
Just so we know.
From both hands.
Entitling persons with disabilities to be enabled.
Okay. Does everybody agree? Like I made the motion?
All in favor? All in favor.
All in favor.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
There you go.
There you go, son.
I think that passed.
Great.
Tell you what, we're excited. And you know what? That makes it really simple for us, right? You know, my biggest thing as I started thinking about this, promoting a new perspective on disability. First thing anybody asks is, what's your perspective? I think we can tell them now, can't we? And I think any one of you can tell people. And that's what's exciting to me.
I have been blind now 23 years. And I went for physical therapy, I would go on about. My doctor's going, you know, they do the list. Have you done anything that has impeded your daily living? And I said, no. And the doctor says, yes, you do. You're blind. And I looked at him and said, I forgot. Because I'm living my life.
Yeah.
If I still have my kid, I still have everything. I, you know, I'm still whatever. But I am Joanne. I'm the mother. I'm this. I'm that. I come and harass on Rob. You know, I have everybody.
You are fully enabled.
But and then by the way, I'm blind too. You know, or I say I'm blind. You know, just so you know, I'm blind, and then I carry on with my life. You know, like it's just
you're fully enabled. That's the goal, guys. Everyone who walks in here, we all have a responsibility.
There's a light at the end of that tunnel.
Okay.
Bad idea to put it up in the walls.
That's what I was thinking.
Put it on the wall.
Can we have a guy at the reception desk?
We can get it done, you know.
We can work on a craft for it, yeah.
We can do a nice craft with it. That'd be fun.
Like fancy handles.
Yeah, no, we should put it up
somewhere. Yeah, I'll put that
up.
Maybe
a
couple
of places.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad you
guys like the slogan.
I think it's awesome.
Do
you think that up,
though?
I didn't do anything.
Okay.
It
was me.
Should I say?
Yeah. I was going to say, can we make, draw a logan of it, and then we can maybe make, have somebody... print it up and put it on the side?
Whatever you like.
Yeah.
Yeah, we can do that.
I mean, just so you know.
Using craft supplies.
The national logo is going to stay, okay? It's going to stay here.
Yeah.
But.
The tag underneath.
The tag underneath could be changed.
The Sudbury chapter wants, or the Sudbury whatever.
No, I think you can just, instead of putting in promoting a new perspective on disability, just take out those words.
Mm-hmm.
And replace it.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. We're really excited with the new approach. Because I think it's empowering for you guys. I think it's exciting.
It's brand new.
It's new.
I think it may even shake government up a little bit when they see proposals with their tech line. Because they're going to go, they got a different mindset.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For
yeah,
sure.
Agree.
You know? Yeah. And that's the people you got to catch.
Have connections with them.
First time I saw that word enable was on my computer. When a program is not working, you have to enable it. That means get it going. So
energy.
People, yes. Enable. You're doing something.
We are enable. Yes.
I have to excuse myself. My first thing is
yeah, okay. So, okay. I don't think we have anything else, but I want to close the floor, allowing the members to speak if you wish. So I wanted to get the meeting done. Does anyone else want to say anything further? Okay, Teresa.
I just wanted to say about this one-on-one position. I'd like to just be a volunteer and do it.
Okay. Well, we will talk to Rob and see what we can do. Anything else?
He's coming. One of the drivers over there.
Pardon, Brian?
What about the elevator? Everything's been about, like, you know, you need grants and all that, but.
Yeah. I think you're saying.
Huh? Are we still doing the about the elevator?
Yeah. I hope so, Brian.
Yeah.
I hope so.
Okay, you take care, girl. Thank you for all your help.
Oh, he drove this long.
Does anybody want to say any words?
Jay, maybe back up and pull grass and
Is anyone where's the thermometer? Should we put it up?
Yes.
Your foot.
No, it's okay. It's just going to be a bit easier. All right.
Okay. Yeah, we should move the thermometer.
Yeah.
But
By the way, I don't need a motion, but the meeting's adjourned. I didn't hear anybody else want to make comments, but if you do, the floor is now open. So I'm gonna say going once.
Well, Kim wants to say something.
Yeah.
How much money did we make, Kim?
Kim, tell me.
How much money did we make?
$2,350.
$350.
That's amazing. Can I propose a long-term goal?
Right? Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Scotty, if not you know me, and because of the vanity we got from one gentleman here, but he said amazing, so we accept that, but Rob says amazing grace to everybody. I need some help from you people, come on. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. That saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. What blind, but now I see. Good enough?
Yeah. Rob loves saying the word amazing. I have a long-term goal proposal.
Oh, you got it?
Thanks everyone, we had fun.
I'd like to say a big thank you to Mr. Tigolo and Earl Black.
What? Supportive housing for members?
I don't think so.
Sure.
If you want.
Absolutely.
Yeah. A lot of us, we don't like long building we're in.
I
don't.
I get them.
Yeah, you take care of it. Yeah.
We're working on it.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
It'll take a few years.
And everybody, my mom is going through major surgery tomorrow.